In my lab, I'm interested in kidney disease, and the kidney model that we look at is a disease model where it affects 1 in 500 to 1 in 1,000 people in the population, called polycystic kidney disease. What happens in this disease is the kidney filters, the nephrons, develop very large cystic structures. The kidneys grow massively, very massive, many, many times the normal size of the kidney. Eventually, they have to be removed and replaced with a kidney transplant. The disease mostly affects people after the age of 50. Depending upon the particular mutations in the two genes, PKD1 and PKD2, that are associated with the disease, those will affect the etiology, the onset of the disease. We generated the polycystic kidney disease model here using the Chang stem cell engineering facility. The way we model this disease in the laboratory is through an approach where we take stem cells, human stem cells, and we generate mini kidney structures in the dish. So we can generate normal mini kidney structures, but if those mini kidney structures have mutations within these genes, PKD1 or PKD2, then instead of generating normal kidneys, they will generate cysts. And so we can follow that cyst-forming process and try and identify the cyst-forming mechanisms and potentially take drugs to see whether we can block those cyst-forming processes. So we feel that a better understanding of the underlying nature of why cysts form when these genes are function of these genes is missing will give us new insight into how we can go about looking for relevant drugs that would be more specific for tackling the problems of polycystic kidney disease and have less off-target effects on other tissues. The approach that we're using to model kidney disease is a generally very powerful approach that you're going to see more and more. The ability to take pluripotent stem cells, to generate designer mutations using gene editing, and then the ability to make complex structures that mirror many organ systems in our body to then study within those organoid systems the nature of the disease.